gentlemen, and welcome to the Palace Theatre. As The Woman in White takes place in Victorian times, it predates the invention of personal photography, video recording, and mobile phones. We would be grateful if you would refrain from their use. Your conductor for this evening's performance is Mr. Stephen Brooker. Thank you.
It's something I can't share with you. help you to get home.
I've no home at all. Nothing but my secret. I have just my secret.
Afraid. What was I saying? Oh, mostly my desire, a quiet atmosphere, as silent as a sepulchre, the utterance of a
Mr. Philip,
just nod your head if you can care. I trust you like it fair.
If I practice what you preach.
light in her hair.
I must disregard his charms and his manly ragged arms.
Thank you. Thank you.
get outside till you see sense, my girl.
What's wrong, Sean?
She didn't believe me. She said it was him and Tails.
Said what?
Do you believe in ghosts, sir?
Well, I believe the dead go on. That we carry them in sight.
I saw a ghost, sir. Yesterday in the gloaming. All in white, sir. Just a ghost, chimney.
Ghost of a woman.
That's right, sir. A woman, all in white.
Where did you see her?
Over there, sir. In the graveyard, sir. It's scared me after death.
Drinking den.
It's safe to say you've
value your position
more than anything at all.
Since we both were children, Laura sometimes sleepwalks. I would wake and find her on the stair, unaware of how she got there. More than her half sister, I am her whole family, and I must protect her.
What reason do you tell me this?
I know, sir, what your secret is.
I have no secrets here.
My sister is engaged to a man of sterling character, a title man of pride, a man her father chose.
What?
Glad you did tell me this.
Then Laura will marry another.
You must crush all feeling for her. There can be no hope of any attachment, no hope of any future. Sorry if this hurts you.
Are you sorry, Miss Harper? Perhaps I'm not the only one with secrets. Feelings that I'd rather hide.
You are most unkind. You have said enough. You should go. I'm doing this to help you. To save you from yourself.
I'd like to know his name.
His name is not your business.
Please let me know his name.
Thank you. guest. You might choose this moment to get out of sight, for knowing me, not knowing how they most guest. I am pleased to meet the blushing bride.
Actually, I'm just the blushing bridesmaid.
Pardon me, it's just that you're so beautiful, which is why I thought you might be glad to me.
There is no mistaking your apparel, Scone.
I've a reputation that precedes me.
I am Laura's sister sent to welcome you.
May I nibble on the hand that feeds me?
You may dine on any single thing you wish. Though I'd wait for dinner, we're serving fish.
There's no time to sing my many appetites.
You might consider taking smaller bites.
It's so very kind of you to have me here.
You, sir, add some interest to the atmosphere.
I detect a fire beneath your grimy mien.
I regret there's no more time to tarry.
I presume that we'll resume this first at party.
Please, hear me out.
very pressing matter. One that concerns a girl. Her name is Anne, Anne Patrick. She says you've done her wrong. Have you an explanation?
Mr. Hartwright, what impertinence! Know your place, sir.
No, no, Mr. Fairley, I'm glad he asked this. Please, please. I'm happy to clear up the matter of Anne Patrick.
The tale is truly sorrowful, and some would say a tragedy. A story breaks my heart. I don't know where to start. Her mother was an admired woman. Your brother recommended her. Recall she worked here to me.
Patrick, I'm not sure of Anne, thank you.
Anne was so sweet as a little. She seemed to laugh all the time. She sparkled like the sun. Such a pretty woman. Yet she grew up so unhappy, sullen and angry and sad. She was a troubled child, acting strange and wild.
She once attacked her mother when she was but 15.
A fury which she opposed. No one knew the cause. To help her grieving mother and rescue Anne's, I undertook her care. I tried to see her through. It was a Christian thing. When no physician treated her, I found a haven that lived, a trusted private place to embrace her case. Anne thinks of me as her captain. Well, I am truly her friend for all her care I pay. Still, she runs away.
I'm touched by your compassion. Your kindness does no harm.
I've done the best I can. I've done my best for Anne.
She spoke to her of a secret she would tell.
The world has come to be but a fantasy. But a safe return is my great concern, and I am grateful.
Thank you. Oh.
Posse.
I bet.
We must see to business. I'll be in my study.
There is something wrong.
She is just tired.
No, I'm still
tired. Oh, she will come now. You live in her shop.
If I do, it's because I'm comfortable there.
She gives love. But you, Miss Hope, you are beyond all compare.
Thank you. Miss Hulk, forgive me. I did not mean to stir. I saw that your room, it was empty. And I thought you might be out here, counting your English sheep. The Cobell.
I couldn't sleep.
Oh, wondering about in the dark. And without the aid of a coat. You English ladies, you are so reckless with your midnight flitting. You must allow me to accompany you home.
No, there's no need.
You are shivering, Miss Hulk. Peer to your chair. Take my gun. Perhaps a bottle.
Thank you.
What was that? How should we come?
Thank you. insult like this. Please don't leave me.
We must know of their next move.
There's a lot at stake.
It's a large amount.
20,000 of us in her bank account. She will never sign. One will twist her arm.
It's a novel thought. Put the price on child.
I was not cut out for a diplomat.
There are other means, but can
see a cat.
We just need the new plan.
But I need the money now.
Let me think, my friend, there's always a solution. Just be patient, you're a hard one to convince. And the elegance is in the execution. We can have our cake and not leave fingerprints.
But I
think both of us could use a shot of brandy. Wait, another course of action's coming clear.
Blind cow.
Blind. Told me.
We have simply got to build a better mousetrap. We will not emerge the victor as it stands. Go and do whatever diet is required. I prefer to have an eating from her hands. I can guarantee that this will help you sleep.
No, I feel quite fine.
To be a good girl, drink this now. I have the servants change your gown.
No, thank you.
I am the doctor, I know best. And I prescribe a good night's rest. There we are. There you are. Very carefully. Little sleep. Just a step. There. There.
Until you die!
Help me! Perhaps I'm not the only one with secrets! I am a it is the edge. I am so terribly sorry.
There is no easy way for me to say this. Your sister. She is dead. She was walking in her sleep.
What did you say?
She had sent her maid away, as was her custom, I understand. She walked to the window, and she fell from a great height. Her husband, she found her this morning, lying on the ground like a little broken bird. He is beside himself with grief. Is that tragic accident? Miss Holcomb. Maggie. I am so deeply sorry. I must go to London today. But if you need anything at all, this is where you will find me. Not that day, tomorrow.
And the life, saith the Lord. Whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Thank you. word!
Thank you.
right. The kids I know him. I'll take you to him. I know him, I'll take you to where he will be. Delighted to help you, believe you in.
them if we find and catch it. I believe her secret is the key.
Oscar has a document. Tell us where she'll be.
Can you find her?
This is here in London.
We must somehow find a way inside.
I think the Count will welcome me.
Good. Then I'll take care of the light.
Will you really come with me? Will you really help me?
Seems my calendar is free.
Now we must find a new home,
and I see you're not lost. Now we have won, and we have only spoils. We must see that we don't miss the boat. And you'll forgive me if I take this moment to gloat. You can get away with everything. It all comes down to style. You'll have a captive audience as long as you're beguiled. Yes, you can have your cake and eat it. The love of those whom you betray. But you can't get away with anything if you don't get away. So, it's ciao to the English way and ciao to the awful cuisine. I admit that I'm a criminal obsessed with perfect crime. But even one as good as I can bungle it sometimes. Yes, even one who is a genius can now and then get in a scrape. But no endeavor's a catastrophe as long as you escape. So, we are off. Out the door. We'll pack our bags, my little friends, and leave to see what we have been at. And long before the story ends, as when we had repented and seen us, we all have got to stop from passing us. But only some of us are not seen us. A few will still be back between us. That comes from being truly living us. You can get away with everything to prove it is my sport. I live to push the boundaries, to break the rules. In short, one must be something of a bounder if one intends to play this game. There's only one thing that one has to have. One has to have no shame. Yes, I can get away with everything because I have no
successive day was getting dull.
Oh, I somehow thought you might be
missing me.
I must tell you, scarlet is your colour.
I cannot spend all my time in mourning. Ruin everywhere I find this, my sister.
Throwing your display a healthy out of June.
I'm for the first time on my own.
You need not be alone. One should explore one's place aside.
You are a guide who's qualified.
I've been in mourning for the continent.
In my provincial world, I cannot be content.
We could lead a life that would be well respected.
And I have no doubt I could be thrilling. But alas, it seems my glass requires refilling.
Oh. Bravo! As your buckles are undone. I would walk to Warsaw just to see your stocking, or to see your check and your... I would come.
You should know it took great courage for this visit. But I must admit I'm glad that I am here.
And that dress you're falling out of is exquisite.
I'm trembling, it is clearly not from fear.
So apparent we were made for one another. We're each other's moon and sun, we're so well matched. Though my feelings are remotely like a brother, we are over 21 and unattached.
I've been waiting all my life for an adventure.
What in truth you have been waiting for is me. Let us begin and be duet. Open up the world of only hunger.
Introduce me to the world beyond my dream.
We'll share secrets that will never breed a partner. A muted pursuit of pleasure to extremes. You and I are willing to defy convention. You're my equal, both each other, even men. We find one another worthy of attention. We don't care what others think or what you want to do. Then I'll fly back to your side, just like a star.
Yes.
chin is even softer than it, baby. Let's resume our tete-a-tete to where we were.
Though my heart says yes, my head's now saying maybe. Though my feet are growing colder,
I concur. When I left this room, were we both not on fire? Were we both about to give romance a whirl?
On reflection, I found out I'm somewhat shyer. And perhaps I'm looking for that kind of girl.
It'll be years that you'll have lost your taste for kissing. And I'd appreciate if your return was missing.
Please let me go.
This day is through. Think you'll be, but think about what might have been if you would have let romance begin. Instead of hiding in your shell, one day you'll see what you have spun, my precious gift, and you'll return the gift of living. Well!
Here. I feel so
been so brave.
Is booked. Sir, your signature.
it is yours. Spend it wisely, blind.
Thank you kindly, sir.
Tragic that she died. Just one silent prayer in memory of my niece.
I have to catch my train.
May we rest in peace.
But, sir, I can't miss the train.
So, I'm alone and homeless now. Darkness is creeping in, brother. Memories, long buried, ringing in my mind. Whisperings from the grave. I'm tired. I cannot hold on. Just leave me in peace.
She's fresh and blood, sir.
What, Marion?
The niece that you mourn is as alive as you are.
You don't understand. Why are you tormenting me like this?
Your niece has been most grievously wronged, sir. On that terrible night, my husband drugged me and dressed me in Anne Catrick's clothing.
It was Anne Catrick who fell to her death that same night.
What fantasy is this?
When I awoke, I was in an asylum. I told my captors my name, but they would not acknowledge me. Laura was imprisoned, and Anne Catrick was buried in her place. It was Fosco's plan.
But Glyde carried it out. We cannot rest until these men are brought to justice.
Anne Catrick lies in my grave.
I wanted her dead, and her secret buried with her.
Uncle, you must tell us if you know anything at all about Anne Catrick. You must tell us.
She was your sister. She was your sister born out of wedlock.
I don't understand.
There was a pretty young girl in service here. Her name was Catherine. My brother's weak and handsome, and what happens behind closed doors?
What do you mean?
A girl was born a year before, Lord. When the resemblance between you became too striking, she. Catherine, the child, was sent to Glyde's residence out of sight and out of mind.
She was my sister.
What happened to her there? What was Anne's secret?
And I do not know. She was Glyde's responsibility, and I have responsibilities of my own.
And Glyde is the only one who can tell us. He alone knows this secret.
He's gone. He left for the continent.
What?
He was here! He left just before your arrived.
To catch the London train.
I believe so.
Marion, Anne was my sister. My own flesh and blood. She was my sister.
We will find these men and we will bring them to justice. The end is appointed. The end is drawing us on.
I've done nothing wrong! Oh, my God. Anne Catrick? This is a real thing. This cannot be. You do not exist. Get away from me!
While I'm here, and you will say, sir, you must confess.
Woman, stay away!
Tell the truth first, hide. You'll hear my voice inside your head, but all your life, and when you're dead, you won't be free till you express what you have done, till you confess. You cannot hide, you can't move on. Everywhere you go, I'll be where you are. I know what you've done, people know it's true.
Thank you. You know that you belong together.